So welcome all, myself Vinayak Kulkarni. So today we will start here the next session on the subject logical connectives and tautology. This is the same part from the mathematical logic. Okay. So in this video series, basically we are going to see conditional, biconditional and tautology. So we are concentrating on these three concepts. The first one is the conditional. So here the important thing to understand is P conditional Q is generated by this way. Here the arrow is pointing from P to Q. The arrow head is pointing from P to Q. It is read as if P then Q. It is read as if P. So these are the underlined words are important, and it is called as conditional statement. If P then Q. P is called as antecedent and Q is called as consequent. P is called as antecedent and Q is called as consequent. Okay. In case of P conditional Q. So here that we have to find out the truth table. So whenever I will only show you the unique condition, whenever the value of P is true and the value of Q is false, at that time P conditional Q is false, otherwise it is true. Whenever the value of antecedent is true and value of consequent is false, at that time P conditional Q is false, otherwise it is true. So whenever we will see the truth table, we are going to see the unique condition. Okay. So otherwise it is true, it is shown here. So this will be the truth table for conditional. Then here we have to calculate Q conditional P. In case of Q conditional P, Q is antecedent. I will write here A and T, antecedent, and Q P is consequent. So in this case, I will check the condition where I will get a combination antecedent value is true and consequent value as false. At that time it is only false, otherwise it is true. So whenever the antecedent value is true and consequent value is false, at that time only the conditional value is false. In this case Q conditional P is false at row 3. There we will get this particular combination. Value of Q is true and value of P is false. So here for a statement formula, P conditional Q is called as conditional statement, Q conditional P is called as converse of P conditional Q. Next, negation of P conditional negation of Q is called inverse of P conditional Q. Negation of Q conditional negation of P is called contrapositive of P conditional Q. Okay, so all these are some of the important points. So in case of conditional, there exists a converse, there exists a inverse, there exists a contrapositive. All the conventions are important. I will repeat it again. For a conditional, there exists a converse. Converse is Q conditional P. Inverse is negation of P conditional negation of Q. Contrapositive is negation of P Q conditional negation of P. So here the biconditional, if P and Q are any two statement, then the statement P biconditional Q. So it is shown by using the double arrow here. The arrow head is pointing from P and Q, and it is read as P if and only if Q, or P I double F if Q. Okay, P if and only if Q, or P if Q. I double F. Okay, it's called as biconditional statement. So what, how to calculate truth table for biconditional? Here whenever the truth values are same, that is either PQ will have the truth value as both having truth value as true or both having truth value as false, at that time only P biconditional Q is true. So what it means, whenever I am having the combination like this, P value true, Q true, at that time P biconditional Q is true. Whenever I am having the combination as P false, then P biconditional Q is false. Otherwise it is P biconditional Q is true. Otherwise it is false. So this is the simple table for biconditional. So by using this approach, we will solve one example on truth table. So here we have so all the things are taken. Negation is calculated already. We have seen the negation in our previous video lecture also. So it is easy to calculate. Just we will concentrate on the other remaining parts which are kept as a blank. So we will solve those. So P and Q. So I will get here true. Then I will get here false. So how I am getting here false? Whenever both the values are true, then only it is true. Otherwise it is false. Then I will negate this particular column. I will negate this particular column. Here I am getting F. Then here I am getting T. Here I am getting T. Okay, exactly opposite symbol I will write. Next, negation of P or negation of Q. Next, negation of P or negation of Q. So here negation P and negation Q. So I will take these two columns here, and there is a operation of disjunction. So here first I will get F, then I will get T, then I will get T, then I will get T. So this is the my final answer for negation of P or negation of Q. Then I have to solve what? I have to solve this. I will write this as 1. I will write this as 2. So I have to go for 1 biconditional 2. 1 biconditional 2. That will be the my final column Y. So why I have written here Y? So as I am denoting just that particular statement formula by using some standard alphabet. So it is called as Y. So here for biconditional, whenever both the values are same, then I can call it as true, T. Okay, so this will be the final answer for the given problem. So next concept we have to understand, the concept of tautology. So I will go to this example again. Here in this case, if you have seen that we got the value as all the values as true. Where which values we have considered in? So I will show here. I will highlight by green color so it will look okay. So we are comparing this final column value. Final column value. So check the final column truth value. Contains all T, it is called as tautology. Contains all F, it is called as contradiction. Contains combinations of T and F, it is called as contingency or satisfiable. So in this case, the final column truth table value can be divided into three different aspects. The first is tautology, all the values are true. Second is contradiction, that is false, all the values are false. Third is contingency or satisfiable, where all the combinations are either true and false. So definition of tautology, a statement formula is called tautology if it always have a truth value T, irrespective of the truth value assigned to its variable. Okay, so what is meaning of this particular statement? I will explain on the next page. So we will take this one example, P or negation P. So I will write here P or negation P. Here I am having only one variable, so I will write here combination as T and F. Negation of P will become F T. Okay, so here P or negation P will become true. So irrespective of assigning value to the variable P, here for this variable either I can assign a value as true false or false true. So that only two combinations. Irrespective of this, the value of truth value of this particular variable P, the value of this particular statement formula P or negation P is always true. In that case we will call this as a tautology. So here it has shown only this thing P and negation P and P conditional P. Okay, all these are the standard examples. In every case we are not getting the value as true, Whenever we will get the value as 2, we call it as tautology, irrespective of truth values assigned to its variable. Whenever we will get false, we will call it as contradiction. So we will solve the two problems on tautology. So first problem is here P conditional, Q conditional P. So we will solve first the part of bracket here. Then we will go to the whole formula Q conditional P. In case of Q conditional P, we will consider the column Q first, then column P second. So here I am getting here false, otherwise it is true. Okay, so I am just looking for antecedent as true and consequent as false. So I will get here this thing. Next is P. Next is here P conditional Q conditional P. So here this will be the first column, this will be the second column, and there we have the operation of conditional. So here I am getting the value as 2, then it is 2, then it is both false 2, then it is both false, false, false 2. So here I am getting all the values are true, because here no combinations, like P are having true and Q implies P having as a false. So here no combination is like this, so I am getting all the values as true. So this is an example of tautology. So the given formula, given statement formula is tautology. Next is P and Q and negation of P or Q. So we will solve it by some, we will divide this problem P and Q. So here I am getting value as true, then false, then false, then false. Next P or Q, so I am getting value as true, 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 false. Then I will negate this particular column, I will get value as F, 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 T. Okay, for the final answer, I am going to use these two columns. So I will connect these two columns. So in that case, P and Q is first, and second one is negation of P or Q. So in that case, the operation is conjunction. So here, T, F, 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 T, F. So here I am getting all the values as false. All the values as false. So this is an example of contradiction. Nowhere I am getting the combination as both the values are true. So because of that, the answer is of, the final answer is of contradiction. Okay. So in this video lecture, we have seen the two different connectives like conditional and biconditional, and also we have solved the problems on both the examples or both the connectives, conditional and biconditional. Then we have covered the concept of tautology and also some of the problems on tautology. If you like this video, please do subscribe and please press the like button.